Well, hi there, everybody, and good morning to meteorologist Travis Klineski here on this Tuesday morning. Hopefully you can hear me okay. My voice is a little shot. I've been a little under the weather the last couple of days. But, speaking of the weather, we've got some interesting weather here the next couple of days. Some transitions on the way. We've had a nice kind of stretch of warm, dry weather. Now we have seen a few showers and isolated thunder showers out there this morning across central Nebraska that are now shifting to the east. Before we get to that, though, I do want to point out a wind advisory for northwestern Nebraska, and this does include Kippah County in our viewing area till 7 o'clock this evening, starting at 8 o'clock this morning. This is where winds will be fairly strong today, close to an area of low pressure moving up into western South Dakota. The farther away from you get from that area of low pressure, the weaker the winds are, but they still are going to be fairly breezy for many of us going through the day. We'll kind of cover that here in just a little bit. Let's first off show you, there's that area of low pressure. It's kind of tough to see. It's underneath our banner there, and that's where there's a good swath of showers and thunderstorms up there. And then there's a warm front near the Nebraska-South Dakota border. Cold front just off to our west, which really isn't much of a cold front because there's not much cool air behind it. It's almost more like a dry line, so to speak. Now, again, showers and isolated thunderstorms are shifting from central Nebraska, north central Kansas, into the eastern part of those states. So the best chance of rain will eventually move in to the east as you go through the day. And we have that dry air kind of getting sucked into the system, wrapping around the system here across central Nebraska. So I expect a lot of sunshine around the Tri-Cities by mid to late morning as that precipitation shifts off to the east. But if you live in eastern Nebraska, you're going to hold on to that rain probably a little bit longer. In fact, maybe much of the day. Could keep things a little bit cooler. We may have to watch for a little bit of a severe weather threat. We'll keep that chance going for the evening and overnight hours in the southeastern parts of the viewing area. And then eventually, I think by tomorrow morning, we dry things out. Although there could be some clouds that kind of fill in as we go through the day, or at least into the morning tomorrow. That frontal boundary kind of stalls out in the area as kind of a quasi-stationary front, so to speak, kind of meandering back and forth, almost as a little bit of a cold front mixed with a warm front there, just kind of moving back and forth. And that's going to kind of sit in the area for tomorrow. And when we get towards the later afternoon hours, it's going to be a warm day out there. We're going to see showers and storms kind of fire up once again by tomorrow afternoon. And we'll have to watch for that severe weather threat tomorrow afternoon into tomorrow night. And then you see that batch of precipitation in the far left corner of your screen there up by Scott's Bluff, northeast Colorado. That's going to move eastward as a big area of showers, and that's going to bring us the best chance of rain overnight Wednesday night into Thursday morning. So as we look at your forecast for today, first off, again, that severe weather threat. Storm Prediction Center right now just highlighting northeastern Nebraska for a slight risk of severe weather. I wouldn't be surprised if that gets expanded a little bit farther south towards the Lincoln and Beatrice areas down Highway 77 there. I don't think it's going to be a major threat later on today, but something we'll have to watch for. And then tomorrow is kind of the more widespread area of maybe some severe weather late in the afternoon into tomorrow evening. See all the yellow shaded areas, especially focusing on areas just southeast of the Tri-Cities, though. So we'll kind of keep an eye on that as we get into tomorrow. Now for today, temperature-wise, still going to be fairly warm out there, but a little bit cooler than we have been for several days now. Mid and upper 70s up north, some early thunder showers giving way to sunshine. Breezier up north as well, especially up towards Kippah County. Western parts of the viewing area, upper 70s to near 80 degrees, mainly sunny skies, a little bit breezy. Also a little breezy across south central Nebraska, not so much down in northern Kansas. Again, an early thunder shower giving way to lots of sunshine. To the east, that's where showers and thunderstorms are going to last the longest. Right now, I'm going with mid 70s. Would not be surprised, though, to see those temperatures really stay even cooler than that, maybe even upper 60s, if we don't get much of any sunshine in parts of eastern Nebraska. So something we'll have to watch for. It's kind of tough to forecast the eastern parts of the state because of, is that shower and thunderstorm activity going to last or not? Now tonight, dry conditions. Tomorrow morning, dry conditions. Now by tomorrow afternoon, that's when that next round of showers and storms develop. When those will kind of move through overnight Wednesday night into Thursday morning. And again, early Thursday morning, probably the best timing for showers. By Thursday afternoon, I think we're going to be drying things out. We'll be left with cooler and breezy conditions on Thursday, and then temps drop down into the 40s. Thursday night, Friday morning. Friday will be a struggle. We'll be lucky to get up into the lower 60s. Even with lots of sunshine, we're going to have a very blustery wind on Friday. So Friday not an overly pleasant day. It will be chilly for Saturday morning. Heading out to Harvest a Harmony Parade in Grand Island Saturday morning. Be ready to be a little bit cool out there, a little bit chilly. Temperatures in the low 40s to start off, but getting up to around 70 by the afternoon with lots of sunshine. Looks pretty nice over the weekend. Winds picking up again on Sunday and Monday as we push back into the mid-70s. So there you go. That is your forecast for today and for the week to come. Again, not too bad. Very typical for this time of the year as we wrap up the month of September and move into early October. It does look like towards mid-October, still a little ways down the road, we are going to see a pretty good cool spell move back in, but that is still quite a bit of ways away yet. We do have some pretty decent weather ahead of us overall over the next 7 days to come. So until next time, I'm meteorologist Travis Klineski, and I hope you have a good one.